Hi, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Very
good.
Let
me help you. I will keep it for you.
Ah, yes, thank you. This also, if you could.
Up!
Voilà. Yes!
Yes, and the dress! Yeah!
Oh!
Les lunettes?
Let's see here.
I had a lot of fun here 4 years ago.
Hey, what is this with my
We have an announcement to make.
I'm pregnant. I'm kidding.
Yes, we have to do this for a chica chilena.
Bien, ¿y tú?
¿De dónde está usted?
¿Santiago? ¿Cómo de dónde? Ah, de Santiago, sí.
Yo conozco muy el Chile, el norte. Chuquicamata, Calama,
I don't play with actors that much. Just Michael Weatherly.
Well, tell me more about you, about Ziza.
About Ziva?
Ziva, or, Ziva.
Okay. Ziva, let's see, she's finishing up her 5th year with NCIS. She's now an American citizen. At the end of the season seven, which we just wrapped, she becomes an American citizen. She's become a part of this family, NCIS. And she's still getting acquainted, and she's still going through problems with her father, and it goes on and on and on. I miss the theater terribly. I would love to go back. I was just in New York and I was watching plays and I was just thinking as I was sitting down, my gosh, I don't know if I could do that again. You know, you get used to the TV thing. At the beginning, TV feels very foreign because cameras are around you and the level of concentration needs to be incredibly high to be able to really deliver. In the theater, everything's very quiet, and so when the lights go on, you feel like you're on stage and all eyes are on you. And camera is very different. You know, camera, all eyes are not on you. They're on the camera, they're on the microphones, they're on everything else, but they're not on you. And so that's the hard thing, concentration.
Tell me, you've met someone special this morning during your jogging, no?
I had a great morning. I had a beautiful, beautiful morning. I woke up at 4, had a little conversation with my lawyer back in Los Angeles. Not a great way to wake up. And then as I moved through the rest of the morning, the pre-dawn hours, I talked to some of the bats that were hanging out in the belfry just outside of the window of my hotel room. They have bats. And I had a little bit of coffee. And then at around 5:55, I decided, let's go for a run. It's time to shed some of the pounds. So I went for this extraordinary, beautiful sunrise run. And I ran into Roger Moore and his beautiful wife, Kiki. And unfortunately for Roger, Sir Roger, I accosted him and introduced myself boldly and told him that I was a huge fan. And started telling him about the book that he had written last year, My Word is My Bond, and that I loved him. I expressed love. So it was a great morning. I felt it was a harbinger. It must be weird to be Roger Moore, and you walk around and everyone who runs into you, then from that, the rest of their day, they're like, I met James Bond. What a great day. I'm just the hand inside the puppet, right? And so the hand doesn't care about being recognized. It's more about the puppet. And I think Dinozzo is a great character, a great creation. He's very fun. He's very optimistic. He's very innocent in a way, and I think one of the things that audiences like about him is even if he's inappropriate, you feel his heart is a good heart. And I'm very fond of him.
You're a dangerous woman.
Who am I getting? Agent Dunham.
Why would you want Dunham? I thought we were talking about Pak Soo Gee.
Dunham is from Texas. I like Texas. What is that saying anyway? He cleans up nice.
Not that nice. I thought he was kind of creepy.
Oh, come on, stop being such a big brother. He's a field agent, a nomad. I've had enough of that in my life.
I came to NCIS to settle down, to make a home for myself.
The last thing I need is a Chad Dunham. Hmm. However...
What?
Well, to answer your question, how would I get him? Brute force is very intriguing.
And who exactly are we talking about right now? Pak Soo-ji or the Texas Longhorn?